I wonder if you've ever been in a huge crowd, massive crowd, and felt more alone than at any other time in your life. If that's been your feeling or you're feeling that way even now, you need to hear this message. My name is Reverend Kwame Rubadiri and you're watching CITAM Church Online. Being alone is very different from being lonely. It's possible for you to be by yourself, but still feel connected, still feel a part of things that are going on around you, still feel connected to the people who are closest to you in your family. Now, we've talked about family being the safest place, or should be the safest place on earth, and family should be the place where you feel the most connection. It should be the place where you feel that everyone around you is really genuinely interested and concerned about your well-being. Now, a young man by the name Joseph, born into a big family, the favorite son of a very rich and wealthy father, doting on him, taking an interest in him, but also becoming the most hated son because of the interest his father Jacob had taken in him. Jacob had taken such an interest in his son Joseph that he almost neglected the fact that his other sons, his other children, were turning against their brother. Jacob didn't seem to even notice the fact that the brothers weren't speaking well to their brother Joseph. They weren't treating him nicely. And so when he sends him off to go and look for his brothers, he does it very casually. He says, go and check on your brothers and see how they're doing, not knowing that he's sending his son into, as it were, the jaws of the lion. When Joseph finds his brothers, he finds them taking care of sheep, but they've already plotted, hatched a plan to take him out. First of all, to kill him, and then eventually they decide that they're going to sell him into slavery. He's sold into slavery. Now, for me, this is probably the most, the greatest picture of being alone or being lonely that you could ever imagine. Here is Joseph. Because of the way his father has treated him, his brothers hate him, and now his brothers have turned against him. And they have not only threatened to kill him, but now they've actually sold him into slavery. And not just to somebody in the neighborhood, they've sold him to a group of people who have taken him to a whole new country, to a different culture altogether. Joseph not only finds himself alone and lonely, but with no prospect that his own family will ever come looking for him, because he knows it's his own brothers, his own flesh and blood, who sold him into slavery. So they're not going to come and rescue him for any reason at all. That's perhaps the loneliest condition that any person could find themselves in. That not that your friends are not interested in helping you, but that your own family, your flesh and blood, have no interest in your well-being. That, I think, is the height of loneliness in human society, in human life. And if you find yourself in a situation like that, you need to hear about how God helped Joseph in this situation, because that is the solution of how you recover. Not that you live a life of a loner, or live a life by yourself, detached from everyone, detached from your family. I've met people who have told me that they have no interest whatsoever in connecting with their family members in particular. And they're happy to live their own lives and have had no contact with members of their family. That is not a scenario that will help or heal a situation where a person feels lonely. You don't deal with loneliness by continuing to remain in that condition. And there are solutions, and I hope that you'll stay with us right here on CITAM Church Online to find those solutions, to deal with and overcome a sense of being alone, especially being alone from your family. You may be listening to this by yourself, and you're thinking to yourself, this message was really for me. I don't feel a sense of connection to anybody who I grew up with or anyone who calls themselves a member of my family. If it is for you, you need to come and talk to us. You need to come to CITAM Parklands. We're on 2nd Parklands Avenue. It's a big white and red building on 2nd Parklands Avenue. We're open throughout the week, working hours, Monday through Saturday. And we have two services on Sunday at 8:30 and 11:30. We hope that you will come. and become part of not just the wider family of God, but find ways in which you can be restored to your family and deal with the demon of loneliness. It is my joy to be able to share this with you. My name is Reverend Kwame Rubadiri, and you've been watching CITAM Church Online.